Hola, somos La Contra.
Y tenemos tres preguntas para...
Andruyan. ¿Sabéis que por el espacio en la Vía Láctea está el Voyager con música que nos representa a la raza humana? Por si nos encuentran los extraterrestres, esta señora con Carl Sagan, es la viuda de Carl Sagan, coautora con Carl Sagan.
El gran Carl Sagan.
El gran Carl Sagan. Cosmos, sí. El programa más visto de la historia de la televisión. Esta señora eligió esa música. ¿Por qué eligió esas canciones, precisamente?
We wanted to represent as many of the world's musical traditions as we possibly could. There is a Senegalese percussion piece, a Japanese shakuhachi piece, an Indian vocal raga, a Bulgarian shepherdess, Blind Willie Johnson singing Dark Was the Night, Chuck Berry doing Johnny Be Good, and Louis Armstrong doing Melancholy Blues, and a Mexican popular song called El Cascabel, Mozart, Queen of the Night aria, Beethoven, Bach, Stravinsky. We wanted to be as eclectic as possible and to present to these extraterrestrials of our imagination how rich and diverse the musical history of our planet is.
¿Qué más hay en esa grabación que vuela por el espacio?
The end of the record is in a way to personally the most fascinating. I had asked Carl Sagan if it were possible for me to be hooked up to an electroencephalogram recording my thoughts and an electrocardiogram recording my heart sounds. So I asked Carl if I were to meditate for an hour hooked up to all this machinery, was it conceivable that the extraterrestrials of the distant future of other worlds and times would be able to decipher my thoughts. And I remember Carl smiling at me, beautiful June day, and saying, a billion years is a long time, Annie, go do it. So I went to Bellevue Hospital in New York City, and I entered this dark room, blindfolded, earmuffs, so I couldn't hear anything. And I thought for an hour, telling the story of the planet, but culminating in the feelings of soaring joy that I felt, because it was only days after Carl and I, after knowing each other for many years, had finally declared to each other how deeply in love with each other we were.
Explícanos el secreto. ¿Cómo es posible que Cosmos, un programa de astronomía, de cosmología, tuviera ese éxito universal espectacular que aún tiene? ¿Cuál es el misterio?
What Carl wanted us to do was to turn away from magical thinking, from superstition, from fear, and to look squarely at ourselves and the future the way that science looks at nature, not seeking to be confirmed in our fears and our prejudices, but really what real love is looking at the other as he or she really is, not imposing our fantasy on the other. And that's what he was saying about nature, that we have to look squarely at nature, at our role in how we take care of our environment, and we have to change. So that if we truly love our children, we have two together, if we really love our children and our grandchildren, we have four, it means to take the reality that the scientists have been telling us about for 75 or 100 years and to act.